Hi, I'm Alan Little, Ask Woodman on YouTube. I'm also one of the owners of Very Super Cool Tools. And today I want to start a new project that I think is going to be really exciting for a lot of people to see. And that's going to be a portable stand made out of steel that's going to have a Biesemeyer guide rail set up on it that's going to allow anybody with a benchtop table saw, a Ryobi, a Bosch, a Rigid, a DeWalt or a Makita saw to drop their benchtop saw into this unit, level it up the way it needs to be, and then be able to have a full Biesemeyer guide rail setup using the Very Super Cool Tools fence as the fence, and have basically stationary saw capacity in a job site portable unit. And I'm going to make this out of steel because steel is what I prefer to build in. I don't want to build this out of aluminum. The weight is not really an issue for me. I would much rather have something that can't be damaged as it gets thrown into the back of pickup trucks and into job site trailers and things like that than the softness of aluminum. It's one thing for the T-square, the aluminum extrusion up on top of the protected table saw top. That's one thing. But the structure, no way would I build that in aluminum. So it's going to be all steel. Then it's going to have a plywood laminate multifunction top as the extension table. But it's going to be pretty exciting. So I've got steel behind me that I picked up at Westbrook Metals yesterday. And I actually had to buy more than I wanted to because they didn't have very many drops for me to choose from. So I had to buy full length pieces. But it's no big deal. I'll end up using it because I'm a metal guy anyway. So let's look at the drawing, and I'm going to show you how I'm going to get started. And I'm just going to buck my primary pieces to length, and then I'm going to there's just a little bit of welding that needs to be done on this, and then I'm going to take care of that welding, and then it should be ready for assembly. So it's not a complicated thing. It's going to be really simple, but incredibly stout and versatile. So let's look at the drawing that Jeff did for me first. Okay, well, I think this drawing may be a little bit skewed in the way the camera's seeing it. These legs are not splayed. They're going to be at 90 degrees, and these are just going to be pipe legs that fit into these receivers that are going to be welded onto plates that'll be bolted onto the bottom. At first, I was just going to weld these stubs onto the bottom of the angle iron, but I didn't want to make any kind of distortion in the angle iron. But you know, I may do it after all, but I think I'm just going to weld these stubs to plates that'll then get bolted down through the top. And you'll see that I'm going to lop this off here. The original drawing, we were going to have the tubing hang off to the left, but I want everything to be flush to this side so the whole unit could be stood up and tied to the inside of a trailer if need be after the legs are taken off. But so this volume void right here, this is where one of the DeWalt, Ryobi, Bosch, Makita, or Rigid table saw will just fit down in there. And you can see there's going to be levelers on the side. So there's a tray here, and that's what you're seeing right here. Here's our tray that is already formed. I had this done here in Austin at Crip and Sheet Metal. This is 11 gauge plate, and then these are the sides. These are the sides that will come down. So I'll fabricate all the holes and the slots in it as I go along as I'm designing this. And so really what we got going here is these are the main pieces that I'm getting ready to cut right now. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to cut my piece of 3x2 11 gauge tubing. So this is 11 gauge. Tubing, and I'm going to cut it to 6 feet long because I want the overall length of this unit to be 6 feet, so it'll fit into the back of a standard American pickup truck. You know, most pickup trucks today have these 6 foot beds on it. That's what mine is. I have a little bit over 6 feet on my Tundra. And so I'm going to cut one piece of tubing at 6 feet, and then we know from our T-square design that you need to have about 7 inches of overhang for the T-square to fully lock onto the top of the unit. And so you can see that in our Very Super Cool Tools blog. There's a sizing diagram if you ever if you're interested in that. I'll post another link on that. So I need to cut two pieces of this 3/16 angle iron, and the reason I went with 3/16 versus quarter inch is just to save a little bit of weight. And so it is going to save some weight on using two pieces of 3/16 versus quarter inch 3x3. So I need to cut those at 65 inches, and what that is that 72 inches minus 7. That's so I'll have two pieces of this. Now this is going to be a 16th of an inch too tall, because normally when you have the 3x2 sitting on a quarter inch angle iron, it's the perfect height for this to be a 16th of an inch below the saw level for the proper step down. So I will clamp these end to end. I'll put a scrap board in there that's a 16th of an inch less, and I'll just grind a 16th of an inch off the top of this. It'll be easy. And this is not that critical. It's the relationship of the tubing to the top of the deck that's important. But I'll be able to grind this really, really accurate with a spacer board in there that I can grind to. The stretchers here, this drawing is not correct. We were going to use a lighter weight angle iron, but I would have had to buy a whole other piece of angle iron, so I'm just going to go ahead and use the 3x3 3/16 drops. I'll just cut some drops, and I need to make three pieces that are 22.5 inches long, and then I'm going to add a quarter inch plate the quarter inch plate at the each end of this, and these are going to have a bolt pattern in it that's going to tie the unit together and form a truss here. And these are just my flats. These are going to be the stretcher flanges is what I'm calling them, and then I'm going to weld some plates onto the bottom of these things here that are going to have threaded receivers in it. There'll be a cylinder, a disc of steel welded onto the bottom, so those will be levelers, and there's going to be stub leg feet. So like I said, I don't want to weld right onto the bottom of the angle iron, because the welder could distort the end of the angle iron. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to weld my stub pieces of 1¼-inch pipe onto some stub flanges, and they'll get bolted down through the top. So that's what I'm doing. So let me get all these pieces cut up. And so here's my steel. I bought full length, so the tubing comes in 24 foot. So I could get 4 out of this if I wanted, but it's just the way, it's just the way you have to buy steel to get the most cost effective price. This piece of 3x2 11 gauge, I think it was $56 for a 24 foot piece. So when you buy full lengths, you get a pretty good price on it.